this thing off. You guys are gonna spit all over it. Hi, Jersey. Hi, John. Hi, kitten. Did everybody? I had to restart, so did everybody refresh? I have no idea. Yeah, everybody click the like button. Hello. Was the screen frozen? Are you biting me? Are you gonna poop? You are so cute. All the legs stayed? I thought I waited. I mean, I'd even close the program and reopened it. Oh well. Oh, happy Valentine's Day. There's a few minutes left. Damn you, John. Are you ready to go buy your after Valentine's Day chocolate, John? Hi, Louise. Hello. Oh, you're so cute. You're so cute. It was nice. I didn't even think about the fact it was Valentine's Day today. It completely just, I worked until 7 o'clock at my client, like just all day straight through. And then I went and did a home visit for one of our sanctuary kitties who's 13 years old, I think. And it was a great apartment. The girl was totally sweet. And I'm really excited for the kitty. So that was a perfect way to celebrate Valentine's Day. Oh my God, your chin. Hey, Darm. Hi, Marie. Oh. only vegan chocolate would go on sale after Valentine's Day, but no. What are you doing up there? Oh, you did? You got love bites, kitten? Oh, I'm gonna check, John. You are so cute. You are adorable. Now I remember that. Hello. What are you doing? Little butt. Oh, lovely people. John's very threatening. He's so scary and mean. Sorry. Hello. It's, don't get me wrong, John can be an ass, but he's not mean. He doesn't, he doesn't go out of his way to get revenge on people. he just doesn't think that way. He doesn't go after people. Well, except for maybe one that's in Canada, but we can't do that yet. But I just don't. Yeah. He's not like devious. John is not a devious human being. Except for when he's hanging out with me. Then I might suck him into some devious thinking and behavior. And especially if me and him and Shelly were together, then we would all be devious for sure. But on his own, John is not a devious human being. Oh my God, Lizzie, you've never received a Valentine's Day gift in your life? Oh, it's only become a thing during the last few years? Okay, now I don't feel so bad. You're devious. Well, that kind of deviousness. Not like prank devious. That's not bad devious. I'm talking about like out to get somebody and to torture them slowly, mentally, physically, emotionally. And that's just not fun when you don't share it with somebody else. Hence why we get more devious when we are together. Yes, baby. What are you doing? See, John said the exact same thing I just said. I did not read. See what I mean? It is best shared, exactly. Hi, Roy. You have to have somebody with you so that when you sit there and you go, ah, somebody's there to hear it and like laugh with you. Oh, Nala. Hi, Paula. Yeah, have you ever hurt John's feelings? Like, he may get angry for a second, but he is one of the few people I know who can legitimately like let things go like rather quickly. Like, he really will let it go. You can hurt his feelings, piss him off, even if you don't necessarily apologize, he can let it go. Where me, I may not torture you, but it'll take me a while to let it go unless you like apologize. And then I can let things go. He just doesn't hand power over to other human beings that easily, which in some ways is healthy. And I'm not that bad. I'm pretty good at not letting people affect me unless I want them to, but it's definitely a skill. I know for myself, I've had to learn how to be a lot less reactionary because of the kitten cam. So, like when I want to jump in and attack somebody for upsetting somebody I care about, I don't necessarily get to do that. I try to be fair and reasonable. But it is hard sometimes. Especially when people say mean things to my moderators and the people who have been in my chat for a really long time. You're funny. Hi, baby. No, we're not mad at each other tonight. I like how Joel says that. Just tonight. Yes, I know. I know. Oh, you're so cute. Why are you smacking me? Oh, look at this belly. It's such a cute belly. Don't punch me. Don't. Wait. Settle down, Missy. Wait. Settle down. I got your face. I got your face. What? Don't attack me. Did she just pass out up there? What are you doing up there? Yeah, she's the one with the chin cooties. Mama. You're so cute. Hi, Dennis. Oh, I'm tired. Mama. How's the weather on the East Coast? Is it still freezing? Is that how the cube keeps ending up in the water fountain? You keep climbing underneath it? Hi, Lori. Oh wow, 62 tomorrow? Nice. Are you guys still being hit hard with the hot weather, Lizzie? Yeah, it actually cooled down here. It was nice. Huh. I just hope I can get back east before it gets hot. I want weather. Hi, Nicole. What are you guys doing? Little troublemakers? Critters. They may just be critters. Go get her. Hey, ghosties. Oh, that's sad, Dennis. How you doing, Darm? Hi, Paula. I don't think I said hi to you. Oh, Coral. What are you doing? What are you doing, Coral? How did you grow up so fast? It's so unfair. Little baby. Feeling me. That's why I try to play the word games and stuff on my phone. Since I don't really have to, I work with numbers a lot during the day, but I don't necessarily deal with words. So I try to play any kind of game like that that makes me spell or count or not use a calculator. Or fit puzzles pieces together. Hey, baby. Good idea, kitten. I never go for walks. I probably should. I can imagine, Lizzie. You may get cooties a lot, but your brain has a lot of work to do. Yeah, knock on some wood, Lizzie. You're lucky. I don't know how, I guess teachers must build up a tolerance. Because I didn't know, my teachers didn't, or maybe they just don't touch the kids. But I don't remember my teachers getting sick all the time. We wished they would. I remember like wishing that a sub would show up and the teachers always showed up. What I did this evening was I worked until 7, and then I was out in the valley, and I, a sanctuary kitty was possibly getting adopted, so they needed somebody to go do a home visit out in the area I was working. So I went, and I did a home visit, and I am very happy that a 13-year-old kitten rescue sanctuary kitty is going to get a home. And then I drove in traffic for 40 minutes. And then I came home to kiss kitties. But the kitty, I have to look it up, the kitty that's getting adopted doesn't really do well surrounded by all these other kitties at the sanctuary. So I think he's gonna be really happy. Yeah, I was really happy that I happened to be in the area and could do it. So that means he can go to his forever home really soon. Like right away. Huh. What are you doing? Oh, that's sad, Rico. Oh, I grew up hanging out in the valley, so I've been half a valley girl my whole life. It's so nice when you go do a home visit and it's easy. Like, their windows were old, so they were really secure, and the screens were really solid, and the only thing I had to warn them about were, like, phone charging wires and stuff, suggesting that, you know, they just keep an eye on him to see what some of his behaviors might be. And other than that, their place was clean. Their bedroom is, like, perfect for starting him out. She already bought food. The food was good. It's very exciting. And she got a food that I haven't, it looks familiar, but I haven't ever tried it. I want to say it's called Love Bowl or something. And it had really good, pretty good ingredients. So, I mean, look at that. Got a thread. You are funny. You're so cute. Keep forgetting to order kibble. Thanks, baby. What kind of webinar? It's so short. Flexible learning spaces? What is that? You're so cute. Oh yeah, that new math stuff is kind of confusing, isn't it? Oh, that is a good idea. Sitting all day long is not good, as most of us adults who sit at desks all day know. Oh, I'll hug her for you.
I know, you're so cute. You are, you're so cute.
Please don't eat my earring. Hey, Meta. The fidgety boys. I'm sure there are fidgety girls too, But I do tend to remember more fidgety boys than girls. But isn't there something, like, don't boys have their growth spurts make them, like, don't boys have more growing pains than girls do? I don't remember ever having growing pains, but I know I had boys, I knew boys that did. Yeah, there's fidgety Nala. Oh, Dennis, you wouldn't make it into the kitten room. You wouldn't make it through the front door. If somebody showed up to my house, they wouldn't make it up the porch if I didn't know them. That's why I like my little street. I know when somebody's coming up my driveway. Yeah, those are from you, just the rolling of your eyes, John. It causes head pain. Night, kitten. Nala reminds me of a little soccer player. A spunky little soccer player. Or maybe she's like one of those like short basketball players on the Lakers that just hop everywhere. Surprisingly, she doesn't play kibble hockey. She likes the ball, but she doesn't play kibble hockey. I think knowledge just has a little extra energy. What are you doing? She does not really play poop hockey. That was more the boys, I think. She likes playing with paper on the tile floor. She does like that ball, but she likes to kick it around, but she likes to grab it and like jump. She likes to leap on top of things, like coral. She likes to claw into things. It's like little Wolverine over here. Yes, Rob is the world champ still. She does like the syringe, that's true. Surprisingly though, she hasn't stolen them from the counter. Knock on wood. What are you doing, baby? Yes, exactly, Noriko. That's what she does. It's like she's diving into the snow. Thank you. Did you find me? Did you find me? Did you find me? Can you guys hear her when she's talking to me in from the bathroom when I'm hiding? Realized Nala was behind me. I thought Coral was peeing in the cube. I was like, is she peeing in there? Oh, thank God you're not peeing in there. She lets me know when she wants me to hide because she'll make her little, like, boop noise. And then when I hide, she keeps chirping at me until she comes looking for me. I hope she keeps playing hide and seek with whoever adopts them. That would be really cute. Oh, me too. I have to go to a client tomorrow too. It's exhausting going to work. Scooping poop and petting cats is enough work on its own. Having to go work elsewhere is very difficult. Huh. It's a full-time job cuddling with kitties. Well, scooping poop is. I feel like I'm always scooping poop. That's why if I can somehow pull it together to build a catio for my cats, then I can let them poop outside and I won't have to scoop as much poop. That's the main reason I need to get them a catio. I don't know how you do it, Lizzie. Teachers are amazing. You not only have to go into a job every day, but you have to go into a job where you're dealing with small little children with cooties and boogers and attitudes and cuteness. But boogers. At least it's good tired. I've been unemployed before and I didn't mind it. As long as I wasn't broke, it was actually pretty cool. I was very lucky in my 20s. I had very good jobs. And I got one of my companies closed down and they gave me 6 months of severance. And I was making very good money, so that 6 months of severance allowed me not to work for quite a while. I should have taken better advantage of it. But unfortunately, there were too many other things happening. What are you doing? I think that I, luckily, because of Facebook, I've gotten to like tell teachers from elementary school how much I appreciated them putting up with me. And they all don't seem to like remember me being horrible, but I wasn't horrible. I was just smart and sarcastic. So I would challenge them. And they would let me get away with it a lot more than I think they let other kids get away with it. But I definitely pushed them at times. Hi, Luna. Thanks, Luna. Coral. I know, it blows me away how big she's gotten too. I don't know how it happens so fast. She's still so cute though and dainty. You, baby. Are you sleepy? Are you? So cute. That little face. Hi, baby. Good night, Lizzie. You're nuts. You are.
And you're just sweet.
She's a little crazy.
I need to go to sleep. But you're so cute.
Good night, John. Don't forget to get your chocolate tomorrow. Your stockpile.
You're so cute. Oh, this face is so cute.
Hi, Helene. Oh, little baby.
Little baby.
Hey, so you know what though? You might accidentally scar me for life. Why do you look like you're about to leap up on my face? Are you done yet? Are you tired? I think my cats are running around now. Your ears are a little dirty. What's going on with that? Is it just that side? You guys aren't cleaning each other's ears very well, are you? I'm gonna have to clean your ears and your chin tomorrow. She's just never. She's telling me stop. Hey, baby. Oh, are you gonna stop and lay down up there? I think she just got tired. Did you just get sleepy? Or are you faking me out? Oh, you faked me out. Why are you staring me down? What are you doing? Oh, your little hair. I forgot my hair. What are you doing? What are you doing? My face. What are you doing? Don't ruin my cardboard. Hello. Oh, don't you dare. Don't you dare try to jump up there. Are you trying to get behind that? Alright, I'm gonna wait for you for bed. Maybe I'll give you some duck. Maybe I'll give you some X-Cat duck. Since your Aunt Lizzie sent it. A little nighttime snack. She's just not giving up. Alright. Let's get you some snacky. Can I get up? Attacking me.